Hello everyone and welcome back to the Warrior Cat Sims 3 Legacy Challenge, and we are here with another Behind the Paws episode. And in this episode we are going to be putting together the MeadowClan camp, and I'm really excited about that because so many of you have requested that you can see how I put the camps together, and a lot of you guys have actually requested that I put the camps up on the exchange for you to download. We'll have to see if that's something we'll end up doing. I'm definitely open to that, but I use so many mods in my game, I'm just not sure if they would download effectively for you guys. But if that's the case, I would be very happy to be able to provide the lots and let you guys use them in your worlds. So if you're interested in having the Moss Clan camp, if you're interested in having the Branch Clan camp, or even the Petal Clan camp, I'm actually thinking we might call them Meadow Clan, depending, but it'll be Petal Clan's Meadow, basically. And the fourth clan is already planned, though you guys just haven't had a chance to see them yet, and I don't think they'll be appearing for a little while because we have so many mysteries to solve as it is. But if you guys want to have the lots on the exchange or maybe on our website once I get it up and going, let me know, but be aware that it would require a few mods, and it would require probably that you have all of the expansion packs and a whole bunch of the stuff packs for The Sims 3. So I'll try to make a little list and we'll figure it out and we'll see if you guys can have them, but it would be really fun to be able to have you like play generations of Moss Clan and Branch Clan in your own right. Oh gosh, that'd be so exciting. But all right, enough rambling. So where are we and where are we making MeadowClan camp? Well, MeadowClan is going to be our third clan, and it's going to be a little bit of a distance away from where Mossclan's up here. Here is the horse riding area. Some of you guys may remember on our quest to go rescue Doge's and the big equestrian center that's right next to it. And then up here, these are the cliffs of Moss Clan. So there's their little waterfall in the distance, not Star Falls, but the waterfall that's next to Moss Clan camp. There's their lake, and here is their big meadow that they have. So this is where Moss Clan is. Technically, it's close enough for a cat to easily walk there until you hit the fact that there's a giant cliff in the way. So we don't need to worry about that big cliff. And then Branch Clan is way down here. You can see the rocks of Branch Clan's beaches right in this section. So they're way over there. And so down the street from the odd herb place, the apothecary that's right over here, is going to be MeadowClan. I'm still deciding on the name. I need your guys' help on figuring out, should we call it MeadowClan or PetalClan? Petal Star is the leader of this clan, and she has a bit of a meadow that we deal with. So we're going to be building a meadow today. It's kind of already a meadow, but we definitely need to add in some barriers so that you can't really see the cats in their meadow as easily from the road, because this is very close to a lot of two-legged territory. Over here is the barn that a lot of you guys are probably familiar with, especially if you watch our 101 Dalmatians challenge. Then yes, that is the family farm and the family barn that you may remember from that series. I totally love this place, and it is going to be a place that we're going to be doing a Behind the Paws revamp in the future, so that during the cold seasons especially, we can go there and we can try to steal kitty pet food and we can try to steal some of the mice. But there's a lot of other cats and there's a lot of two legs that we might risk running into over here. It's a bit of a trade-off. And then right over here is actually the meeting place. If I go a little bit further, this is it. One of these two places is the meeting place for when we have, oh, over here, this is it, because it has all of the trees blockading it. That's kind of what we're going to be doing in the camp today. But this is where we have the meeting place during the full moons, and we do need to start doing that again, having some gatherings. But you know, tensions between our first two clans are pretty high right now, so we'll have to see how that works out. And then up there is where Star Falls is, so technically the clan that would take this area over would stand to kind of be in control of the entrance to Star Falls, where the medicine cats, I don't know so much about Bear Glow, but where the medicine cats are supposed to go in order to communicate with Star Clan once a month. All of those things we'll probably be playing with a little bit more in season 2, so you can expect that with a lot of excitement. Otherwise, the junkyard from when we rescued Doge's is right down here, and this is just a empty forest meadow that is also prime hunting territory for the lucky clan who may be nearby. The only downside is you may notice we're hedged in by two thunder paths, and our other two clans have really tried to stay super wild and away from such dangerous things. things, but this clan would be awful close to those thunderpaths, so hopefully they'd be safe, and there would be a lot of two-legs coming to this area, though there is a nice little pond over here that if they really need a drink, they could come and get a drink from, or they could search around this area and see if there's any herbs or any interesting items. It looks like there's a little tree, a bunch of apple trees that we could come over and we could partake of, so we'll have to keep an eye on all those things, but let's go ahead and get our camp defended. First, most important thing we really need to do for camp is get some nice big bushes down. So we want to make sure that, you know, the two legs can't just stroll into our territory. And we'll get some nice trees down, though really this camp is going to be much more about having this big open meadow to be able to be inside of, but we do want to enclose it a little bit. So let me dig out some of my rocks, and the rocks I have, I will be doing a Behind the Paws mod spotlight on some of my favorite plant and rock decorations, which sounds boring, but those of you who have tried to build camps for your clans know how important it is, but I'll be doing a Behind the Paws episode on that. And let's see, lots of rocks, lots of flat rocks. There's a ton of them that are just from different versions of the game. You can see the little icons. These are normal, but then these ones I think were from, I think, the island. So yeah, the Island Paradise expansion. I think these ones are from the World Adventures expansion. So the more expansions and stuff packs you have for Sims, as usual, the more stuff you have to pick from. And I also need to turn on some of my little cheats. Let me do move objects on. On, there we go, nut onion. And now we can blend together the plants and the rocks just like that. Alright, so let's go ahead and grab some big rocks, because I definitely want to make sure this camp is pretty defended, just not something that looks like a two-leg would just casually walk into. Maybe some like random big boulders just mixed in, maybe right over here. And you can blend the rocks together to make really interesting formations, and it also gives quite a varied look to the landscape. I really like doing that quite often. There we go. And then you can get some little rocks just to make sure it looks a little bit more natural. And then let's see. I need some big rocks. It's really hard to get like big rocks. There we go. Like the contemplative stone. That'll do. But you don't have to use boulders and rocks everywhere. It just helps to kind of start marking areas off. And yeah, if you move them around, you can sometimes get the boulders to like sit on top of each other, and you can make some really interesting shapes with that. It just depends on the size of their footprint. All right, there we go. Footprint is what you refer to as the grid that these things use. See, look at that. What an interesting boulder we just made. Just smacking a few of them together. And then let's go up here and let's see. Yeah, I just want a few of them casually scattered on the perimeter of camp. Or I should say the clan territory. There we go, because that will block Sims from being able just to stroll straight in. But we're going to put down a lot of bushes and a lot of trees. We're really just kind of enclosing the area, and then we'll zoom in kind of over here. Kind of a bad sign if there's a large space rock. And we're going to turn this particular area into the camp proper. So let's get started on... and I also should do another wonderful cheat that I always use. And that's going to be... let's see. Testing cheats enabled on. And we're also going to need the hidden objects cheat, which I forgot. So 1 second. Oh, it's so easy. I always forget because it's so easy and it's so different from The Sims 4, but it's just by debug. There we go. Haha! And now you can see where the spawners happen to be all over the land. So we're going to casually remove this meteor spawner because I do not need meteorites falling on our nurseries once more. But you can see there's a lot of wildflower spawners, which would be really great. And I'm going to put a ton of them down because we are going to have a lot of wildflowers popping up in this meadow. And that would be really great if we were MossClan. And one of the things, and those of you who are watching this will kind of have the Behind the Paws spoilers, so if you're not ready for a couple spoilers, then be prepared. But one of the things that is really going to separate the MeadowClan is that they have a lot of resources, but they don't have many ways to be able to use them. They may have a ton of plants, a ton of flowers, but they don't really have any way to use those flowers the way that MossClan can. So MossClan might have to start trading with them at some point in the future, depending on how things fall out with this clan, of course. And I guess we'll call them MeadowClan for now. I really like that idea. I think MeadowClan kind of works out versus MeadowClan, I think. But again, again, I'll wait till I get some of your guys' opinions on that. But MeadowClan can't really use the plants the way that MossClan can to be able to grow new things and to really make their clan prosper. MossClan can give the flowers to their spirit of the land, and there will be a spirit of the land for MeadowClan as well. And they can use them to be able to grow new plants or give Willow the energy she needs to do fancy things to help protect the clan. And MeadowClan can't do that because that's not what their spirit of the land does. Their spirit of the land will do something different, so, and need different things for it. So let's go ahead and put these down. And then I'm going to put some over here too. There we go. And we'll have to make like a little blockade of these bushes. We want it to keep the open meadow feeling, but we don't want it to look like, oh, hey, any old two-leg can just stroll in here, no problem. We have enough problem with campers and adventurers coming into MossClan territory. Oddly enough, no one's ever come over to BranchClan territory now that I think about it, other than the creepy ice cream truck. That creepy ice cream truck does show up pretty often. But yeah, they won't be able to use all the flowers that they grow, but because it's a nice big open meadow and it's not as shadowy as MossClan's forests are, they get more flowers, and it creates a little bit of a push and a pull between the clans to see who has the resources and who doesn't. And how are they going to either work together, which is not something that happens in the Warrior Cats books. But keep in mind, we're always looking for ways to kind of give our own unique spin on the Warrior Cats stories, especially because we're an original world. And especially because it's really boring not to have the clans interact a little bit more, I think. You want to have the fights, you want to have the drama, but our random generators will be more than adequate with being able to keep the cats from getting a little bit too friendly with each other. Let's see, at least most of the time. Or they might make the cats get way too friendly with each other. It's going to depend. And we don't want to just make a solid line like we kind of are right now. You want to vary it up a little bit. Tug the bushes. Like right here, I'm starting to make it so there's like a branching path between the areas, so it's not just like a straight line. Yeah, see how we've like wibbled the bushes and kind of given it a more naturalistic look as a result. If you just line things up like a straight hedge like this fence, then it looks artificial. And we'll do a few of them over here. And yes, there's a certain cat running through the fields spoiling some secrets, but I'm gonna leave him there. And then you guys who are watching this will have had like the sneak peek of like, look who it is, and everybody else will miss out because you guys you'll know that something's going to happen with that particular cat in the future. All right, I'm gonna put these down just kind of to line some things up. We do have to be careful because the bushes do represent a barrier, so you need to leave open some areas. But that's kind of what I did over here. Leave an area open, but put the bushes a little bit further back, and it does create a good spot, let's see, where you have that privacy and nobody's going to be peeking in and seeing what your mysterious cats are up to. And we'll do this, maybe a couple more. See, so it makes that like naturalistic barrier, but you still have paths that the cats will be able to use to work their way into their territory. All right, there we go. Maybe we'll put them on this side of the tree. Yeah, who would want to go in there? See, it's all crowded and clustered. Could be uncomfortable for all you know. Full of thorns and chiggers and ticks. You want to avoid that. Oh, that reminds me. We probably need to add some sort of like parasite problem in with our cats that they'd have to cope with unless they had a handy dandy medicine cat available. Alright, so there's kind of the outline of the border of the clan territory. This would be their main territory. All the clans tend to have two or three other areas that they also wander, but MeadowClan really is going to have to rely on this little space that it's got and then this space over here. There's a huge risk in going across to the barn to be able to hunt the rodents that live there because there's barn cats who are probably not going to be very eager to just fork over some of their territory to you. And there's also two legs who are constantly trying to catch the cats, and different things will happen if a two leg catches a cat. The cat may come back like spayed or neutered, so they can't have kits anymore. They may never come back. They may be adopted and turned into a kitty pet somewhere in the like far distance of the world. They may end up like coming back and being medically cured, or they may end up just like disappearing forever and we never know what happens to them. So all sorts of things could happen when you're a two-leg. They may even end up becoming friends with a kitty pet and bringing that kitty pet back. We'll just have to see. But all right, now that we have the outline of the meadow done, we need to figure out where we're going to put some things. And I also have some very, very special downloads. Like I said, I'll do a downloads overview one day in the future. But these are beautiful wisterias. Look at them. I got them from a Tumblr called Crowlandia, and I saw them and knew as soon as I saw them that is what we need for this clan. Because this is perfect. Look at these beautiful, beautiful plants. Wisterias are one of my favorite flowers, and they will be great for being able to just focus. I can't zoom in when I'm in build mode, but they'll be great for being able to make this area feel like it's just overflowing with flowers. And that's really the vibe we're going for. So I'm going to be removing some of the dead grass, and we're going to be sprinkling the wisterias out and about in the land. And we might even replace some of the bushes and trees we put down with them. And there's different colors of wisterias, including a white wisteria. So they just add a lot of beauty. I hope they move. That would be really cool if they actually move too. They add a lot of beauty to the land. There we go. Lovely. And you don't need many of them. We could go all out like a cherry blossom forest and just put a ton of them down. Wow, look at this pink one. But only a few are really needed to make the point of how gorgeous this area is with the wisterias. So we'll put down a couple of each. That's very, very lovely. I think the spirit of the land I have in mind for this area would really love this spot. I think we'll focus mostly on like the pinks and the purples because that really goes with Petal Star. You may have noticed she has some purple hues on her. There's a very special reason for that. You will see, you will see. And no, she's not related to Bear Glow. I didn't realize making two white cats suddenly means they're immediately related, but I should have remembered because everybody was like, Crow Feather and Branch Star, totally related. Because they're both tuxedos. And that wasn't really the case, but you know what? We ran with it and it turned out to be pretty awesome. Look at them. This is the first time I've seen them in game, but these are the low violet shrublooms and the white violet shrublooms. And oh my goodness. Yeah, this is going to make MeadowClan just really shine with the flowers of the meadow. There's also several very unique and beautiful flowers. We may save these anemones for the future because there is a very special requirement that this spirit of the land has in taking care of herself and being able to give a very special trade-off for what she provides to the clan. Just like the others, Slate, our spirit of the land for Branch Clan, provides fish. Willow provides all sorts of healing herbs. And this particular spirit of the land provides something special too. And oh, look at these flowers. Yeah, I will definitely have to collect these. There's little white flowering bushes. Oh my gosh, they're so lovely. And it's so nice to have something that just looks a little different. Look at them. And then I have a white rose bush. Oh, so pretty. Except the roses also have thorns. So, we'll have to think about that. I think we may actually take out a few of these bushes and replace them with the white rose bushes. And I wonder if we should make this the medicine cat territory. By the rose bushes. I think we will. We'll go ahead. We're going to put down just a few main spots. I think that the medicine cat will have her area over here by the rose bushes. So I'm going to clear out a few of these bushes. We might get some of the shrubs. Would they go in here? Ooh, look at these. They're so pretty. All right, we're going to sprinkle these white flowers down. So the area where all these white flowers grow will be the medicine cat's territory. I already have the medicine cat in mind. We may end up making them later in another Behind the Paws. It's really fun to do this with you guys and kind of show you like some sneak peeks. And you can see some more. Oh, look at these gladiolus. Oh my gosh, they're gorgeous. Oh, I love them. And we can just like sprinkle some of those flowers in at random. Actually, I think instead of that guy, look at that beautiful pink bloom. Gosh, that's lovely. I think that that... Maybe we'll put a couple of them down, but I think a little ring of those would be perfect for marking out a spot where the medicine, or where the leader actually hangs out. So let's see. What else do we have? Let's get these white rose shrubs over here. And I think that the medicine cat may have a little bit of a silly sense of humor about having white rose bushes, which are full of thorns and kind of prickly, line her area. Like, probably something like life has its prickly moments or something like that. All right, we're gonna put that down. A few over here, a couple over here. And by mixing in some of these other bushes, it really helps to just give it, and if you're having trouble with like the size of the bushes in Sims 3, there we go. If you put one down and then like remove it, you should get a new size the next time. If you find that they're just like too big, you need a smaller bush. There we go. All right, we can probably remove this gem spawner, but I'll scooch over the wildflower spawner and I'll scooch this ruby over there. Might as well leave some of the treasure that the clan can stumble on when they move in. And we need to put down some moss beds over here in just a moment, but we have where I think the medicine cat will make her territory, right under this big tree where it's nice and shady, next to some of the wisterias, all these little white flowers. Very nice, and she can kind of look over the whole camp this way. And then we'll come over here, and I think we're going to turn this into where we can have our nursery. And so it's got to be ultra secure. If we're going to stick, the nursery is clearly going to be in like the most secure section of the entire area, because this is a clan in particular who really is a little bit obsessed with kits, as you guys will see soon. All right, so we're gonna give it a nice little rock shelter. That definitely looks kind of artificial. So then what you can do is you can grab some stones of various sizes and smack them against as soon as I find a various size. Hey, come on, be a little, there we go, contemplative stone. There we go. And the stones that I just used are mod downloads from around the Sims. But I will say that if you don't have them, then having the Island Paradise, these seem to be the best stones to mix in. There we go, a little weird bouldery thing going on there. And then maybe another one over here? I think once we add in some bushes, it'll help it feel a little bit more natural. Yeah, I think we'll do just the boulders at the back and then maybe a couple big trees to provide some shade and shelter. Whoa! Yes! Look at this wisteria tree! Oh my gosh. That would definitely announce this is the deepest part of clan territory. Right over here with this gigantic wisteria tree. Like, this is perfect. This is going to be the tree under which we have all of our meetings, that's for sure. All right, and then over here, whew, that tree's huge and beautiful. All right, over here we could have creepy trees. None of the other trees feel as grandiose after running into that one. There's beautiful magnolia trees, little bushes. We need a nice big tree, a scotchy pine tree. There's a pink wisteria tree. Gosh, that's so lovely. But we need a nice big tree with a big tree trunk to sort of tuck into the background here. So I might have to just go to my default bushes that I always use. Oh, this tree shrub will probably do. This is kind of what I was talking about. Just to provide like some shelter, some shade. Make sure that it's clear that the cats can get out of the elements when it rains. There we go. And then the kits can be nice and safe and they'll have their own little spot. Perfect. See a nice little sheltered spot, and the kits will be back here. They can play and frolic to their heart's content. So we're gonna move some of these plants out of the way. And we're gonna put down some of the moss beds. We're gonna put down, let's put down some of these shrubs. There are thorn shrubs that would kind of block the kits from easily leaving camp, or I should say easily leaving the nursery at least. But let's swap some of these in. There we go. Just a nice little line, and this will kind of define like the edge of the nursery territory. All right, and then the leader's territory. She's going to have something pretty special. We're gonna give her her own little secret spot, especially all considering she also needs a spot where we'll say that this tree may be very, very related to her spirit of the land. So let's see. Oh my goodness, look at all these plants. Oh, I love them. Oh, we definitely need to sprinkle some of the heather and stuff like that down. Maybe some of these. Yeah, maybe we'll put down a lot of these little patches of clover kind of in the sunlight. this is going to be an extremely inviting nursery. So you really want to make it look super duper nice to convince the kits that it's totally a-okay. There we go. And if you hold Alt down on the keyboard, then you can escape the grids and you can sprinkle your plants a little bit more naturally on everything you run into. But we're going to make several patches of moss, or well, this is actually like clover, but we'll say it's kind of like the soft patches of moss that the cats can lay in. And let's see, maybe just vary that up a little bit. If you make a perfect circle out of it, it's probably not going to look very natural. So by just kind of gently twisting and turning, there you go. And making it look a little bit more like little random patches. Sometimes several of them overlapping can give a curve where a lot of things in The Sims want to do straight lines. There we go. That looks very comfy. Wonderful. And then we're going to come in. I think that we're going to have this area behind here end up being where our clan leader and her, our clan leader and her spirit of the land are going to be. So let me sprinkle these over here. Just a nice little circle ring. Kind of indicate, oh my gosh, these flowers are beautiful. We'll have to just do patches of them scattered throughout the whole area. Oh, and we'll have to get rid of all of these patches. Now that a spirit of the land has come in, there's going to be a lot of health in this area, and probably the spirit of the land herself is pretty good at keeping overly curious two legs from wandering into her territory, her domain. There we go. And then the other thing we need to sprinkle all over the meadow in just a moment here. Let's get a whole bunch of these flowers put down first so it looks really nice. And we're also going to change this area so it looks a lot brighter on the ground cover. And yes, there is this much work that goes into planning everything and trying to make it look so nice before we start sharing it with you guys. All right, clover. And put that, ooh, woohoo, that's really bright. Oh my goodness. And then there's white flowers. Let's see, yellow flowers. Whoa, holy days. That's a little bit brighter than what I was going for, but actually that could probably work in increments. Let's do just a really nice bright grass first. And look at that, that's so bright. Okay, what about Hidden Springs grass? This is a good mix of it though. Ridiculously bright. There's always going to be just something about this area. Yeah, I might do some like overlays like bluegrass. There we go. I think the bluegrass is more what we're going for, kind of mixed in on top with the other colors. But yeah, this particular meadow is always going to seem a little bit brighter than anywhere else in the world. And it almost has a bit of an eerie quality to it. Kind of like if you wandered into a spot that had a bunch of fairies and it seems really beautiful, but there's just something and you can't quite put your finger on it that's a little bit off too. So we'll do that. And we've got a few little patches of the dead grass to remove. And we won't like trip every single corner out with plants just yet. We do have to give MeadowClan something to work towards because they are a newer clan. They haven't been established for forever. Petal Star is the first one to have actually gotten the clan up and going. So we have to appropriately show that clan growing, just like Mossleaf had to grow Moss Clan with Lion Star. I love how much we've done with all of the clans. All right, let's see. There we go. Which one is your guys, I guess favorite is a strong word because there's all sorts of different stories each clan has to offer, but are you guys happy with how the clans have developed? It's really hard to make them actually, considering we're working with a game that changes the plot and the rules on its own, but I'm pretty proud of what we've done. All right, and a little bit more here and there. Oh, that's so satisfying. There, look at how bright and beautiful this has turned into. Holy moly, this is quite lovely. I think I'm gonna remove some of the purple heather patches just here and there and swap them out with these low white blossoms because wow, those are gorgeous and they are perfect and atmospheric for what we're going for. And we'll sprinkle a few of them down here. There we go. And a few more over here. There we go. So I'm happy with that. And I think we'll over time, like, remove these blue blossoms because they kind of don't match, and we'll swap in some of the other blossoms. Like these little pink guys totally match, and we can kind of just sprinkle them in at random. And this is a very beautiful place. I think even the cats would be able to agree. This is a very lovely place. There's something very special about it. Let's come over here. Do I have a tree trunk of some kind? I have a giant fairy mushroom. Not quite what we're going for. A charred tree, a scorched tree. Interesting. I just want a large tree trunk would be awesome. After so many years of owning Sims 3, I'm always constantly finding things I didn't expect still. To this day, there's lots of surprises in what it has to offer you. All right, so I think that's pretty good. We'll have to find, like, where are we gonna put the prey pile? And something tells me it'll be kind of near the nursery, so I think we'll put our prey pile probably over here. So if we're gonna do that, let me make a little section. And we will kind of surround it with some of the smaller rocks just to sort of mark it off. So we'll put down some of these nice pieces and maybe a piece over here. And we'll open this up a little bit more. There we go. And maybe a larger rock. So you can use a lot of the landscaping, and if you just don't make strict, like I see a lot of people try to make a border and they make it like really, really strict, like razor line straight, and it doesn't have the organic nature-y look that they wanted and they get frustrated. So I highly recommend if you're trying to like make an outline of something to overlay the rocks to kind of make it look like, okay, come here, alt, da-da-da-da-da. There we go. Overlay the rocks and just make it look pretty, not entirely a straight line, but you know, you get the idea of what we're going for. So there we go. And I'll have to see, I'm pretty sure I have some tree trunks sitting inside of my modded folder section, so I'll dig into that. And then another tip that somebody recommended ages and ages ago, and it took me a little while to warm up to it, but it's totally been a great idea: put down some really like light colored sand spot. There we go. And then that will let you actually see what the heck you're looking at. And you can even do little patches of just like light patches of dirt and then sand again to get different tones, so it doesn't look quite like sand if you happen to be in the middle of a forest like we are. But that'll give it a little clear patch of ground so you can see what kind of prey you have piled in your prey pile. So that works out. And look how quickly the camp has come together already. And now we are going to be popping into buy mode, and we're going to be looking for... And... you can see because I have turned on debug, we will be working with the spawners there in just a second. But now we need the pet essentials. A few things I still need to download before... yeah, there's a few things I still need to download that you guys have linked me to that would be really great recolored pet abodes. But for now, we're still working with, say, like the Bow Wowser pet bed. That's a big moss thing that I've just put down the grass textures and saved it. So there's one of the big moss beds. And some more dead grass. We'll go ahead and remove that now that we have such beautiful, beautiful flowers all over the place and a spirit of the land taking residence. And then I'm going to put this one over here. These are the big moss beds. They're very useful for nurseries so that you can have one of the parent cats snuggle with their kit. And then I'm going to come over and we'll put another one here in the medicine cat camp because that works really well with medicine cats. And then we are going to actually make a new pet house coloration. And this one, whoopsie daisy, I deleted the whole thing, don't do that. But this one is going to be where the tree trunk is on the bottom and it's like leaves and moss on the top. And so all you have to do is look for like the woods, give it kind of a natural looking wood thing. Let's see, I wonder if we've got like nature. There should be like a nature selection. Miscellaneous has that. Let's see, themed. Nope, we need woods, I think, just plain woods. But this is the create a style wheel. There we go, that's what it's called. And we could make birch. You know what, why not? Let's make the woods birch themed. There we go. And then we can do the whole thing like that, but the top we're actually going to change to be something like leaves. And that's a little tricky, but we'll darken it a little bit And ta-da, there we go. It's kind of like a empty tree trunk, an empty birch tree trunk. And you can actually save the style by hitting save. Oops, nope, we saved that style. That's not quite what I was going for. But we've got that, and now I need to see, can I save your whole style? I'm trying to remember. There we go. And now we have saved the whole style by hitting this little save button up there so that we can just choose that as one of our default pet houses now, the country pet houses. I would still love to be able to commission someone so that we could, or like just beg someone, like, please, I just need some empty tree trunks that could work for cat houses. And things like that to get more naturalistic looks. But I've put out the offer a few times and nobody has taken me up just yet. So I'm not sure if the Sims 3 mod community has just gotten that small or not, but we'll have to see. But all right, we've got several of those pet houses now, especially in the nursery. Like I said, this clan tends to really, really go out of their way for their kits. We are going to put down some of the, we don't want any litter boxes because then the cats will just go wherever. And if you put a litter box into a territory, it's just going to make a big mess because the spirit of the land will spend their entire time having to clean litter boxes. And we want a little moss bed now. So we'll go ahead and snag these small moss beds, and we can just sprinkle those ones around the edges of the nursery. That's really where a lot of the cats of this clan tend to spend their time. But I always find it fun to put some of the moss beds at random elsewhere and not under the big tree though, because that's going to be where a lot of the cats end up meeting. I think this big tree, we can add some moss beds around it. There we go. And then we'll actually add in some bushes perhaps, or maybe some of these low white flowers. I think that'll do. And we do that just to try to very gently hide the moss beds without putting the flowers right on top of the moss bed, or else the cats won't be able to get into it. And then, oh, maybe a little bit of this heather. That's actually kind of nice, like a little compliment to some of the other colors we have. Now let's change the heather out for the purple thing. There we go. Very nice. And then the other thing that we do want to consider is putting in some of the taller pet buildings, the taller pet classic condos. And we actually have some of them. We should actually make one that looks more like a tree, but we'll go ahead and grab those tree patterns and smack them onto this thing. And then we can sprinkle these watchtowers around the camp, and that will actually help out so the cats can feel like they're patrolling and keeping an eye on their territory. And we'll just say this is a funky tree. So we'll go ahead and replace that part. And then we will replace, dun dun dun, this part. And ta-da! Now we've got a whole new cat tree made. And we're done with that. Thank you very much. We can come over here, save the pattern, boom. And even though we can use the eyeglass tool, that means we can make the same birch tree cat lookout for several of the other clans now too. So a whole bunch of the other lots. And as time goes on and clans begin to really like claim specific sorts of territory, we definitely are going to have more cat proper, like cat available items scattered on those lots. Like this lot over here doesn't have any of these nice moss beds, doesn't have any of the cat things that can climb, they can climb on. But as time goes on and the clan may claim those areas, we would add those in. And we'll put a few of these sentry towers. This is one of the biggest camps, another benefit that they get to start with, even if they're going to have a lot of not so great benefits due to their leader. But there we go. Okay, so that is almost everything. And now we actually just need to put down a pet toy crate. And this is actually temporary until we get our paws on a moss ball. And then I can use the testing cheats enabled true and the move objects on cheat to be able to clone the moss ball a few times. But for now, we have to leave this here until like a little paper ball shows up. And the last thing I need to be able to put in, we do need some things that they can scratch on. So I'm going to put down the Fiscus for them to be able to scratch on. And we'll just sprinkle a few of them around. There's some better scratching post out there that I have to get my paws on very soon that you guys have linked me to again and again and again. And I just haven't done it yet, but it'll be a good thing to kind of keep in my little list of future mod suggestions. All right, we'll put this down in the nursery just to make sure the kits can have a place to scratch their paws too. And the very last thing is going to be putting in some prey items. One of the most important things, and you heard it here first, that this clan, MeadowClan, and I'm pretty sure I'm confident in calling it MeadowClan from now on, but that this clan is going to have are bugs, and not just any bugs. They're going to have a very, very, very special kind of insect, if I can also find it. Let's see, beetle spawner, water beetle, stag beetle, spotted beetle, roaches, rhino, rainbow beetles. That is the secret ingredient that gives MeadowClan so much of its power. Rainbow beetles. They get rainbow beetles, the heal all be all of rescuing a kit's life from their spirit of the land. And that's probably too many spawners. We'll have to play with the number. They do have to trade something to their spirit of the land, just like with Slate and Willow, in order to be able to get those rainbow beetles. But the fact is, her presence brings rainbow beetles, the cure-all for kits, into this camp. That means any kit whose life is threatened and it's able to be saved, even minimally, is going to be okay if they have a rainbow beetle, and MeadowClan will have so many of them. So that's going to be something very interesting, very, very, very interesting to deal with. We're also going to leave behind a few butterfly spawners, though who knows what we'll do with those. They might just be around for looky-loos more than anything. All right, so I'll sprinkle some of those around. Lots of flowers, so of course there'd be lots of butterflies. And we are going to add in some rodent spawners because we're not going to be able to eat. And weirdly enough, rodent spawners are actually found inside of the fish spawner area. I don't know why. I'm pretty sure they're found here. At least small bird, there we go. Small bird, snake, turtle spawner, small bird. I guess we'll put down a couple bird spawners. But we won't put too many down because the spawners don't always actually spawn things, but something will always spawn when a cat goes hunting, when they go prowling for something, then they do have something show up. All right, and there's one other, the wonder petal. There we go. That's the other thing that we need to put down in this territory. So I'm gonna sprinkle a few of these wonder petals in. And let's just say they're going to have a very interesting effect on the cats. So you'll want to keep your eyes on those as well. And they too will have a little bit of a trade-off that they'll need to cope with. But yeah, they're gonna be very interesting. The what they do to the cats and how that affects the politics of MeadowClan. But alright, I have rambled on enough. I think we've got everything down that we need. There's going to be a little bit more balance going on as time goes on and making this clan not quite all so powerful. But I'm very excited to share them with you. So this has been a very, very long Behind the Paws episode, but you've seen it from start to finish, jumping on a lot and figuring out how to put things down and how to start making it a proper clan territory. As usual, we will be editing it as time goes on to go with the flow of the seasons, to go with the flow of the plots, and we're going to be a little bit more aggressive about the cats adding their own unique touch, being able to start up a new garden of some sort of special plant they've collected, being able to build a new area. All of that really will make sure that the cats leave a legacy behind to pass on to the next generation of their clan and the other stories we're going to have in our Sims 3 Warrior Cats Challenge. So I hope you guys have enjoyed, and I will see you all next time. Bye-bye.